Welcome to WildernessMaster.com. I'm Luke Stevens, one of your Wilderness Masters here. This video series is WildernessMaster 101. Today we're doing the BasicKnots2. In today's video, we're going to cover three knots. Now these will be functional knots, unlike in BasicKnots1, which was just the kind of knot prototypes. The knots we're going to cover today includes the square knot, the taut line hitch, and the bowline. Now with these three knots, you should be able to function fairly well out there during your outdoor activities. Let's get started. Remember in BasicKnots1, we talked about the half knot. Well, the square knot is just an extension of the half knot where we are including an additional half knot in addition to the original half knot. The only thing that you need to remember when you tie that second half knot, there's the first, is if the right hand line goes over the left hand line, then when you tie the second one, the left hand line goes over the right hand line. And what you result in is a knot that looks like this. That's how you know that that's a good square knot. Notice that you have two what almost look like loops interbinding there. That's a good square knot. Now the whatchamadoodle knot happens as a result of tying a square knot badly. So remember, we went right over left. Well, if we go right over left again, we get the whatchamadoodle knot. And look at what the whatchamadoodle knot does. The whatchamadoodle knot doesn't do a whole lot for you. It may act like it does, but it's really lying to you. So one more time, we're going to tie half knot number one, where we put the right over the left and bring it through. And then we're going to tie half knot number two, where we bring the left over the right and bring it through, and then tighten that down into a perfect little square knot there. Now, square knot's great. It's a binding knot. So for instance, if I wanted to tie this off really good and tight around this kettlebell here, I could tie this off down here, round it, tie it off. Now I've got a nice square knot. Okay? Could tie that down and tighten it as much as I wanted to tighten it. Remember in BasicKnots1 that we talked about the overhand knot. Well, here's one of the places that you can use an overhand knot to help you out. So let's say you're needing to tie something securely and you're afraid that these two ropes might slip. I mean, this is kind of slippery rope. It could happen with this one. Well, what happens if I just tie a little overhand knot here on each side? Find the free end. There we go. Bring it around. Now, if this rope starts slipping through, this overhand knot's going to bind and prevent it from going all the way through and loosening up completely. So that's one of the purposes of the overhand knot, as I discussed in BasicKnots1. It's a great knot for finishing these knots off. So that's the square knot. Another good thing about the square knot, in a bind, let's not consider this was one piece of rope. Let's think of this as two pieces of rope. And we needed to lash a couple of pieces of rope together because we need a little bit longer rope. Well, guess what? We do that. We put those overhand knots to make sure they're not going to pull through. Now we've lashed our rope. Now, generally, for a real heavy load, I wouldn't do that with a square knot. But in a pinch, if you have to and you can't remember, because pretty much everybody remembers square knot, this is a knot you can do that with. Why wouldn't I do it generally? Under load, the square knot tightens down really hard and tight, and it puts all the force in that knot, and sometimes that can cause fatigue or failure in there. So that's the square knot. One last time, right over left, left over right, perfect little square knot there. Excellent. Now let's move to the taut line hitch. We talked about half hitches in BasicKnots1, and today we're going to learn a little bit of a variation. You'll see half hitches in there. But this is a great knot for tying off things that you need to be able to have an adjustment ability. So all you have to do with the taut line hitch is you're going to come through. Let me get enough rope here. Let me flip my rope around. Sorry. Makes it easier to show you. So I'm going to come through. I'm going to go through. I'm going to go back around and back through my rope. And then I'm going to come over one more time and finish it off here. Now, the thing that you have to do with a taut line hitch is you have to tighten this little knot that you're creating here down. And what happens when you do that is now wherever I want to adjust this, I can adjust this out and it holds. So this makes it great. Think about your camping, you're wanting to tie off your tent to your tent stake. You run that thing down there, you tie that taut line hitch down there, you got all this flap in your rope. Well, now you just slide that up till you got all that out. Tighten your little knot down here good, and it holds. Excellent. Now let's tie that taut line hitch one more time. I think my hands might have gotten in the way and kind of blinded you on that one. Okay, again, slide this off. I got to have a little bit more rope for the camera. Okay, we're going to come over. We've got a loop. We're going to feed that around. What is that? That's a half hitch right there, right? Okay, then we're going to follow the same direction with this, except outside the loop on the free end of the rope, we're going to come around, and this time we're going to come through the loop beside this rope right here. Okay? So now we have kind of two half hitches. This is a little bit of a funky one right here. And then we're going to come around one more time outside of the loop. And notice what we've got here. You've got your two half hitches in here. You've got a half hitch here. And when you tighten this down, you tighten it down by grabbing the loop end of that until you get a nice tight ball. And you've got to kind of tighten both ends of it. And then you pull it down good and tight. Here's the free end of the rope. See, this passes through this little knot right here. And now you've got a taut line hitch. Okay, one more time. So we have our half hitch, our first half hitch. Now we're going to half hitch around here and come back through here like that, and then we're going to half hitch one more time outside the loop and bring it down, and that's what that should look like right there. Okay, and then you're going to grab this ball on both ends kind of with your fingers and pull this free end tight, ball that up, get it nice and tight balled down like that. That's a nice, well-dressed taut line hitch right there. And then once you do that, the thing will bind down on itself and hold. Again, this is a lashing knot. It's adjustable, so as soon as you pull on this end of the knot, it releases the pressure. When you pull on this end, it tightens the pressure. Great knot to know. Great knot if you ever need to tie and lash and be able to tighten that lashing. Remember the basic half hitch, which we use multiple times in here. If we tighten this thing down, that half hitch just keeps tightening, 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 tightening. In fact, with just a half hitch, it's going to pull all the way through here, and then you got a problem. It gets caught on the rubber plastic end piece. Okay, so that's the taut line hitch. Great lashing knot, great knot that can be able to loosen and tighten as you need it to be. Now the last knot is often called the king of knots. It's the bowline. Everybody always hears about the bowline. Most people tie it badly, wrongly, or they can't remember it. So let's discuss the bowline. The bowline is really, really simple. The first thing that you need to do is take a bite, and whenever you loop or bite your rope, that's called a bite. When it's done like this, it's called a loop. You're going to take a loop. And notice I grabbed, so if this is the end of the rope that I'm going to tie around something, so let's say I'm lashing it to this kettlebell, that end of the rope, which is the tying end of the rope, I'm going to grab and I'm going to flip so that the tying end goes over the other end. The reason why is, you remember the little thing, the rabbit comes out of the hole, goes around the tree, goes back down in the hole, and that's your bowline knot right there. Well, if you don't loop this initial loop correctly, then all of that's just going to come apart on you. So if I loop it this way, guess what happens? When the rabbit comes out of the hole and goes around and comes back down through the hole here, it just undoes itself. So you always want the end of the rope that you're tying the loop around to be on the bottom of the lashing as you come around. See, this rope comes up through. See how you have the bottom there? Then you're going to go around the tree and back down in. That's a really tight one. We're going to redo it for the camera, and that's what it should look like right there. And look, it tightens up really nice. It's like a noose around that. It will carry loads really well. It doesn't tighten down like the half hitches do, but it does provide a very safe, secure loop. Bowlines are used in a lot of camping stuff. So without the kettlebell, let me do this one more time. Okay, we're going to take the loop. We're going to take the end we're tying around. We're going to come up through that loop like this. In fact, let's tie it right down on here. Okay, that's the rabbit coming out of the hole right there. Then we're going to go around the tree. And we're going to go back down through that hole. We're going to tighten that off right there. It's a perfect bowline. So in today's series, we learned three knots. This is Basic Knots 2. The knots you learned is the square knot, the taut line hitch, and the bowline. These are very functional knots. You can use it for a lot of different purposes. And this should give you a basic knotology for doing your outdoor work. I'm Luke Stevens, one of your Wilderness Masters at WildernessMaster.com.